This video is going to be about solving a system of equations by graphing. So here's a problem. We've got these two equations, y equals 1/2 x minus 4, and y equals negative 2x plus 6. And since this is a system of equations, we can graph them both on the same number line. Now the solution is going to be this. When these graphs cross, it's going to mean that the x and y coordinates for both of the graphs at the same time will be the same. You remember there's any number of solutions to just one equation because the solutions are every point on the number line. And similarly, there's an infinite number of solutions to the second equation. But there's going to be only one solution that works for both of the equations at the same time. So to find that, all we have to do is graph each line and see where they cross. Okay, so to graph the first line, we have y equals 1/2 x minus 4. So first I'm going to find the y-intercept, or the vertical intercept. That's negative 4. So that's going to be down here on my number line. And then looking at the slope, that'll be 1/2. So we're going to go up 1 and over 2. So going back down to that negative 4, I go up 1 and over 2. I go up 1 again and over 2. Going up 1 again and over 2, it'll take me to about here and here. And so what I want to do is take all these dots and connect them with a straight edge. And now I've got this line, and remember, every point on this line is a solution to this first equation. Okay, so actually let's write that equation on the line so we remember which one it is. That's y equals 1/2 x minus 4. Okay, now we graph the second line. That's y equals negative 2x plus 6. So once again, the y-intercept, the vertical intercept, is 6. The slope is negative 2, so that means down 2 and over 1. Down 2 and over 1, down 2 more and over 1, down 2 more and over 1. That'll put us right here. And I'm going to connect these lines, these dots as well. Should be about right. And this line, I'll label it, that's going to be y equals negative 2x plus 6. Y equals negative 2x plus 6. And the point where they cross right here is the point where all of these solutions, we have a pair of solutions that are exactly the same. That's right here. And this point looks like it should be at 4, coming down from the 4, and negative 2. So this point is 4, comma, negative 2. So I can write my answer as just as an ordered pair, 4, negative 2. Or I can write x equals 4, that's what the first part of the ordered pair is about, and y equals negative 2, that's this number here. Okay, so this is my answer written two different ways. If I want to make extra sure that I'm right, I can take the x value and the y value, plug them both into each equation, and make sure the equations balance. So let's see. Doing the first equation, remember y is negative 2 equals 1/2 x is 4, 1/2 times 4, minus 4. Well, negative 2 equals 1/2 times 4 is 2, minus 4. 2 minus 4 is negative 2. So the first equation checks. Using those same values, x equals 4 and y equals negative 2, in my second equation, Let's make sure that one checks. So y is negative 2 equals negative 2 times x is 4 plus 6. Negative 2 equals negative 2 times 4 is negative 8 plus 6. Negative 8 plus 6 is the same as negative 2. So this equation checks also. So this answer is the correct one. Okay, so that's all there is to it. Once again, you're given a pair of equations, a system of two equations, and you're told to solve by graphing. You graph both equations, find the point where they cross, and the x value and the y value for that point will be your solution. So that's it for now. Take care. I'll see you next time.